Good day, students. In this group, we're going to be going over how to evaluate finite limits using analytic and graphical methods. So before we start taking a look at the examples, let's take a look at the steps real quick. So first of all, we have a finite limit problem. First thing we want to do is plug in the constant into the variable. If you get an answer, that's good. If you have an undefined expression, you go to number two. And then step two requires you to do different things depending on what the problem looks like. You can either factor, condense, rationalize, or rewrite the problem, then reduce if possible, and then plug in again. If you get an answer, that's your result. If you have an undefined expression, go to three. And three involves basically using another method, it could be graphical or numerical, to confirm the non-existence of that limit. All right, and then if you end up with the fact that the left and right hand limits are different, then you can conclude for a certainty that that the limit does not exist, okay? So analytic method doesn't really show you that explicitly using the methods we're using right now. So that's why it's good to have confirmation using another method before you conclude that the limit does not exist, okay? All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at question number one. So for one, we wanna evaluate, we wanna find the limit as x approaches 3 of x squared plus 3x plus 9 divided by x plus 3. Okay? Alright, so first thing we're going to do is plug in our substitute, the value that the limit is approaching into the variables here. So we're going to have 3 squared plus 3 times 3 plus 9 over 3 plus 3. Okay, you notice that in the denominator we have a non-zero value, so that indicates that we're not going to have an undefined expression here, which is good. So we don't need to go to step 2 or 3. So let's simplify this, and that will be our result. 3 squared is 9, plus 3 times 3 is 9, plus 9 over 3 plus 3 is 6. So 9 plus 9 plus 9 is the same thing as 9 times 3, which is 27. Over 6, divide top and bottom by 3, your answer will be 9 over 2. Alright, so there goes your final result. Alright, let's take a look at another example. What if we were to find the following, number 2, find the limit as x approaches negative 2 of 2x squared plus 4x over x squared minus 4. Okay? So let's do step one first. Let's substitute x into the value that x is approaching into the variables and see what we get. Okay, so if we do that, we're gonna have 2 times negative 2 squared plus 4 times negative 2 divided by negative 2 squared minus 4. Alright, and let's see what that yields. If you notice in the denominator, we're going to have 4 minus 4, which is 0. Okay, we're going to have something over 0. That means that this expression is going to be undefined. Does that mean that the limit does not exist? No, we need to go to step 2, reduce this completely. I mean, factor this as much as we can, reduce, and then plug in again, okay? So let's factor this expression. Limit as x approaches negative 2. If I factor the numerator, I can factor out the GCF, which is 2x, and I'll be left with x plus 2. And then the denominator, this is a difference of squares. If you remember a difference of squares formula, if you have a squared minus b squared, it factors into the sum of the difference of the square roots. So a plus b times a minus b. All right? So if we factor this, you root x squared and 4, you're going to have x plus 2 times x minus 2. Okay, now we factored, can we reduce here? Absolutely, we can reduce the x plus 2. So x plus 2 goes here 1, x plus 2 goes here 1. So our answer is going to be, it's going to become limit as x approaches negative 2 of 2x divided by x minus 2. All right, so now let's plug in again and see what we get. We're plugging again, we're going to have 2 times negative 2 divided by negative 2 minus 2. All right, and then that's going to give us negative 4 over negative 4, and then your final answer is 1. Okay, so the limit does in fact exist, and the value is positive 1. All right, so the reason why the limit did not exist originally, or we had an undefined output originally, is because we have a discontinuity at that point. At negative 2, we have a discontinuity. It turns out that discontinuity is a removable discontinuity. So that kind of discontinuity does not eliminate the existence of a limit. So if you have a removable discontinuity, a discontinuity that cancels out, in that case, the limit could still exist if the resulting function does not have a discontinuity at that point, okay? So that's why we had a zero initially. So by canceling, we remove the discontinuity and we can actually find the limit, all right? So remember, removable discontinuities are also known as point discontinuities. So if you have a function with a removable discontinuity, the limit still exists because you approach the same value regardless of the direction. But at that point, you have a discontinuity, all right? Okay, now let's consider another problem. In question 3, the instructions are as follows. Attempt to find the limit algebraically or analytically, they mean the same thing. And then confirm your result graphically, okay? All right, so we're gonna be doing this problem in two different ways. Okay, so the problem under consideration is the limit as x approaches 1 of x over x squared minus x, okay? All right, let's go ahead and find this limit. This is gonna be if we plug in 1, let's plug in 1 following step 1 of the procedures I showed you. If I plug in 1, I'm going to have 1 over 1 squared minus 1, which is 1 over 0. That's not good. So let's go to step 2, which involves factoring in this case. We're going to factor, reduce, and then plug in again and see what we get, okay? So now we... Using step 2, we're going to have the limit as x approaches 1 of x over x times x minus 1, okay? Notice by factoring the denominator, we can reduce the x's like that, and then that gives us the limit as x approaches 1 of 1 over x minus 1. Okay, now let's now plug in again. If we plug in again, we'll still end up with 1 over 0. So in this case, it looks like the limit does not exist because we keep getting an undefined expression and this cannot be reduced any further. So what kind of discontinuity exists here? You notice it cannot be removed. The discontinuity here cannot be removed. So it appears as though we have an infinite discontinuity here. So the question is, does it approach the same value of infinity on both sides? So what we have to do is we need to look at the graph to make sure the left and the right hand limits are different, and then we can conclude that the limit does not exist. If they're the same, then the limit does exist, okay? All right, let's take a look at the graph. All right, so there goes my calculator. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna go ahead and plug in the original function into my graphing menu, and then I'm going to generate the graph. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to the graphing window. Diamond Y will take you to the graphing window. So let's enter the function. We're going to have x divided by parentheses x raised to the second power minus x. Enter. Let's verify that the function we have entered is the same as what we have here, so it looks good. All right, let's graph it. Diamond F3 will generate the graph for us. Bam. You see what we have here? So if you look at this graph closely, you notice that we have a discontinuity at this value. What value is it? We're taking a look at 1, right? So let's trace it to the cursor to 1. So you press F3, 1, enter, and then you notice that it's undefined. If you're approaching 1 from the left, you have negative infinity. If you're approaching one from the right, you have infinity. Okay, so the limit does not exist in this case because they're approaching different values. All right, so what we're gonna do, let's make a sketch of the situation and then we'll state what our result is, okay? So this is what the graph looks like. It's not a perfect curve, it's just a sketch. We have an asymptote at, let's go by twos. So this is one, two, three. My x-axis, that's my y-axis. We have an asymptote at x equals 1. On the right side, it goes, it approaches this asymptote and it takes up to infinity, okay, like that. And then the other one from the left side, it goes down in that direction, okay? All right, so from this graphical result, what can we say? What can we conclude here? Graphically, this shows us that the limit as x approaches 1 from the left of the function is negative infinity. How do we know? Because the function is going down forever, all the way down to negative infinity, okay? And on the other side, the limit as x approaches 1 from the right of the function is infinity, because you notice that it goes up forever to infinity. Okay, so remember that when you're approaching a value from this direction, it's 1 from the left, and then when you're approaching from that direction is 1 from the right. All right, so what conclusion can we make here? So since the limit as x approaches 1 from the left is not of the function, so forget that, the function is not equal to the limit as x approaches 1 from the right of the function, that implies that the limit of the function does not exist. Remember, limit as x approaches 1, this is a double-sided limit of the function, does not exist. Okay, so that's the answer for question 2, question number 3. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. You can feel free to subscribe to my channel by clicking up here. And please post a comment to let me know what you think about this clip. More clips can be found on math.serve.com/calculus, so you can just scan this QR code for direct access to the website. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.